Whether you call it Roaccutane, Accutane or Isotretinoin, I'm going to give you some really useful tips that everyone should know whilst taking it. Isotretinoin is one of the very few clinically proven oral treatments for acne, and the results can be pretty impressive. But before you get too excited, please remember that isotretinoin can have some pretty serious side effects which everyone should know. This is why it's recommended that everyone reads the fact sheet on this medicine before they begin taking it. Now, I'll leave a link to this in the description below for everyone to read. This video, however, is more about common side effects and what you can do to help reduce them. So I really hope my tips help you. Now let's begin. Common side effect number one. General dryness of the skin, lips, eyes and nose. This is basically a consequence of one of the ways that isotretinoin works by reducing the natural oils that we secrete. So for the dry skin, use a water-based moisturizer as often as needed. Avoid using thick, greasy moisturizers, however, as it will make your acne worse. For the dry lips, use a lip balm whenever it's needed. Now, if you suffer from dry eyes, an artificial teardrop may be useful for this, and you can pick it up from any pharmacy. Generally speaking, I find hypermellows to be quite useful for this. But if you do wear contact lenses, please let your pharmacist know as it may not be suitable. I also think it's important to remember that whilst you're taking isotretinoin and for 6 months afterwards, your skin is going to be a lot more delicate to waxing, epilation, dermabrasion and laser treatment. So it's best if you avoid these unless you're told otherwise by your healthcare professional. Generally speaking, shaving is okay, but make sure that you moisturize afterwards. Common side effect number two, general dryness in the nose, mouth, throat and even nosebleed. So for the dry nose and nosebleeds, you can apply a very thin layer of petroleum jelly on the outside of the nose. This isn't suitable for children, however. And for the dry mouth and dry throat, you can try chewing gum or sucking on boiled sweets or ice. Common side effect number three, sensitivity to the sun. Please avoid direct sunlight if you're taking isotretinoin, because you're far more likely to burn. So to avoid sunburn, try to keep your skin covered from the sun, and if it's needed, wear a sunscreen and lip balm with a high protection factor, at least SPF 15. Also, I'm sure you won't be using sunbeds, but avoid these at all times. Common side effect four, headaches and pain in your joints, muscles, and back. Now, light exercise should be okay, shouldn't really make this pain worse, but if you're gonna do more heavy exercise, it can sometimes make the pain worse. So if the pain is getting more and you can't bear with it, either speak to your doctor or speak to your pharmacist to recommend you some painkillers. So I've tried to give you the common side effects of isotretinoin that I see on a day-to-day basis and how to prevent them. But please remember, this is not a detailed list of all the side effects of isotretinoin, and if you do want to see that, please check out the links in the description below. Now, I've left more information and really useful links in the description below, which I'd advise everyone to read. And if you have any of your own tips that work well for you, then share the knowledge with everyone else by leaving a comment below. And that's the end of this week's video. I really hope my tips help you. And if you have any further questions about isotretinoin, feel free to leave a comment below and I'll try to get back to you in our responding to your comments series. See you next week. Shaving is generally well tolerated. Isotretinoin is one of the very few clinically common side effect number one. General dryness of the nose, lips, eyes, and something else. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.